Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Let me ask you a question. For those who are vaccinated, I've heard a lot of people say, hey, this Omicron is not too bad. Let's just get it and be over with it. What do you think about that?
Ooh, very dangerous. Very dangerous, Larry. That's playing with dynamite. This is a life-threatening disease. Granted, it's mostly in high-risk people, people with underlying immune conditions and health conditions, and people that are older, but it can really affect anybody, and it's just too dangerous to play with. That's one part of it. The other part is that if everyone says, if they just give up stopping the mitigation efforts with masks and social distancing and whatever, the whole medical system is going to implode. It's already stressed. If everyone just gives up right now, the hospitals are going to collapse.
What about the onslaught of counterfeit N95 masks? How do you spot one of those?
That's a good question, Robin. Not really a detective here, but there are a couple clues because, you know, the mask recommendations are going to get jacked up very soon. Might even be today. But there's no ear loops. There's no decorative findings on the mask. Oftentimes, NIOSH, which is the approving authority for the N95 mask, is spelled wrong. Those are a couple little signs, but you know, just be careful out there because 60% of the KN95 masks are counterfeit. Hmm.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. One person in our house tested positive for COVID Saturday. She had symptoms on Thursday. Why did it take until the next Thursday, a week later, for another member of the family to test positive?
That's normal. It takes 5 to 7 days to get sick after exposure, and it can be up to 14 days.
Mm. All right. Next question. How long will a rapid test stay positive? If the rapid test is positive, does that mean you're still contagious?
The rapid test will stay positive as long as it's detecting antigen in your nasal secretions. So if it's positive, you're likely contagious.
All right. And how soon after receiving a positive PCR test, after having slight symptoms, do you need to wait to retest? A week or more or less?
Don't use the PCR test to see if you're done with the infection, because that's not good for that. It'll pick up molecular particles. It's not infectious. It's a bad test to follow up with.
Hmm.
So to find out if you're not positive anymore, what do you do then?
Do the antigen test.
Okay, gotcha. This next question, if symptoms start followed by a positive test, how can you still test positive 12 days later feeling 100% better?
It depends on what test they had. If it's the antigen test, they're still contagious because you can still be contagious up to 14 days typically. If it's a PCR test, it's meaningless.
Okay, our daughter lives in New York City and says her friends are getting their second case of COVID since the beginning of the pandemic. Is this common?
Yeah, if they had Delta before, it doesn't give any protection against Omicron. So we're seeing that a lot.
Wow.
Omicron right after you have Delta.
Hmm.
All right. This person says we hear so much about Omicron, but how prevalent is the more deadly Delta variant? Tests don't tell us which variant we might have.
You can't order the test, but we do the tests on a population level right now. Less than 10% of the cases are Delta, and it's going down every day. Omicron's taking over.
All right, here's another question. If we had reached herd immunity as of summer of 2021, when everyone 12 and up was eligible to be vaccinated, would the spread of Omicron be as fast spreading and causing breakthroughs as much as it is currently among the vaccinated?
Well, Omicron may be spreading. However, the hospitals would be at their old levels. There would be no crisis in the hospital system, except perhaps with the pediatric cases.
Are we peaking now? I keep hearing we're kind of, are we at the peak of Omicron, you think, or how long?
Well, we are peaking in certain places. The city of Chicago may be peaking. New York may be peaking. Vermont is going down. The United Kingdom is going down. South Africa already has gone down. But some places are still going up.
All right. If you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or go to our Morning News Facebook page, post one there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Thanks, doctor.
Hey, have a great weekend.